Every day, we focus our eyes on the world around us. But what kind of world would we see if we sharpened our focus onto things lying beyond our capacity to see them? The physicist Maximilian Haider wanted to get to the bottom of that question.
What's this seeing?
What is seeing? I can see a house, a ball, or an object. But I can't really see an atom. But he changed that. Haider solved a 60-year-old research problem. And at the end of the 1990s, in his adopted hometown of Heidelberg, he made scientific history. He followed in the footsteps of tradition, because it was another Heidelberger, Ernst Ruska, in the 1930s, who built the first ever electron microscope. Accelerated electron beams hurtle towards the object. With the aid of electromagnetic fields, the beams are focused. This new technology enabled researchers for the first time to detect viruses so small that 20,000 of them, placed side by side, would be just 1 millimeter wide. The view into the nano world had been opened up, but remained hazy because in the years that followed, objects could never be captured in sharp focus, a dilemma that no researcher could resolve. Not during the early 1950s, when Maximilian Haider was born and raised in Austria. Nor in the late 1950s, when little Max attended school there. Nor in the 1960s, when he left junior high school and started training as an optician. But he was far more interested in lenses than in glasses. He set his sights high, taking a special physics study course without a high school diploma. And that brought him into contact with the problem of focusing for the first time. Of course, that was an incentive to really solve the problem once and for all. I was convinced it could be done. And if something's feasible, then you have to do it. Back in the 70s and early 80s, people felt that it wouldn't work, that it would never work. Maximilian Haider is an experimental physicist, and in 1992, he began researching with his group at Heidelberg's EMBL, the European Molecular Biology Laboratory. Also on board in the project group was fellow German colleague Joachim Zach, with whom he founded his company CIOS 4 years later. 5 years went by. While the research world continued to doubt that the venture would succeed, Maximilian Haider always believed that it would. But in the summer of 1997, the deadline was approaching, the project was coming to an end, and the objective had not yet been reached. That was a dramatic time, because back in 1996, we actually managed to show that we could correct aberration. The microscope wasn't stable, though, so the images weren't either. They wobbled, and we couldn't really show the resolution. Yes, those were very dramatic days. The project group managed to locate the error in the area of the intermediate lens. A special lens was designed and built for the system to compensate for the error. But this final effort was still not rewarded with success. We carried out all the steps. In early June, we installed it. Then we switched the beam back on. And what happened? It was still unstable. I got really depressed at that point because I thought it was all over and nothing was going to work anymore. Then, one day later, it had stabilized. The lens was stable. I was just totally relieved. And then we were able to render individual atoms as an image with real clarity. Everything that had appeared double exposed suddenly became sharp. And it wasn't a hair, it was a carbon nanotube that was 100,000 times smaller. The innovation became the world's first correction system for electron microscopes, and Haider had it patented through his company. This also laid the foundations for many subsequent improvements. In 2008, his invention hit the headlines. The potential was immense. Researchers were now able to go into more and more detail with the correctors, recognizing individual atomic layers or measuring molecular structures. Maximilian Haider and Joachim Zach produced the correctors in their company, CIOS. 90% of all transmission electron microscopes worldwide are equipped with their patented correctors. These more powerful microscopes help engineers to fit more and more data into less and less space. The invention is especially beneficial for materials science, whether computer chips, batteries, data storage devices, e-mobility, or semiconductor production. Haider, together with his colleagues, has received prestigious awards for his invention. Joint ventures with research institutes have now resulted in world record resolutions, such as this one at the University of Ulm. For me too, this image is a new milestone in my development. You can see atoms jumping around and migrating, and not in single images, but actually like in a film recording. And that's always fascinating. Maximilian Haider focuses on what fascinates him, whether it's new projects as the senior consultant of his company or in his adopted hometown. In his research, nothing escapes his sharp eyes.